students, now we are going to see example sums in mensuration. Already we saw up to 2.1. Now example 7.22. Calculate the weight of a hollow brass sphere if the inner diameter is 14 cm and thickness is 1 mm and whose density is 17.3 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, see here, calculate the weight of a hollow brass sphere. So what we have to find? Weight of the hollow sphere. Then they are given, what is given? Inner diameter is given and thickness is given. Okay, now see, let small r and capital R be the inner and outer radii of the hollow sphere. Hollow means it has two radiuses. So small r be the radius of inner sphere, inner one, and capital R be the radius of the outer part. Okay, so given that diameter, inner diameter, so small d equal to 14 centimeter. So find radius. How you find? If diameter is given, means you divide that one by 2. So 14 divided by 2 equal to 7. So radius equal to 7 centimeter. And one more data, thickness equal to 1 mm. See here, this is in centimeter, radius is in centimeter, thickness is in millimeter. So you convert this into centimeter. Both measurements are in same unit, so you have to convert millimeter into centimeter. You studied the conversion table in lower classes. 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. So this one, 1 millimeter equal to 1 by 10 centimeter. Is it clear? Because 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. So 1 millimeter equal to what? 1 by 10 centimeter. So I am replacing this 1 millimeter by 1 by 10. Okay, see. 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. That is, you write like this. Equal to 1 centimeter. So 1 millimeter equal to 1. This 10 bring to this side. So 1 by 10 of centimeter. So I am replacing this one here. Okay. Now outer radius, capital R, equal to outer radius. What you have to do? We have to add small radius, inner radius with the thickness. Okay. Small r is given 7. And thickness is here 1 by 10. So 7 plus 1 by 10. That is equal to. So take LCM. That is common denominator. Multiply this 7 into 10. 7 tens are 70 plus 1 by 10. That is equal to 71 by 10. 71 divided by 10 means you get 7.1 centimeter. So outer radius capital R equal to 7.1 centimeter. Next, you have to find volume. Volume of the hollow sphere. The formula is 4 by 3 pi capital R cube minus small r cube cubic units. Substitute the corresponding values. 4 by 3, 22 by 7. See here, capital R is how much? 7.1. So 7.1 the whole cube minus small r is 7. So 7 cube. Cube this one. How you cube this one? 7.1 into 7.1 into 7.1. You multiply, taking the point. First you multiply 71 into 71 into 71. While you are getting one answer, no, in that answer you put here 3 digits, after 3 digits point is there, so you put point. So you are getting 357.91. Then 7 cube, 7 into 7 into 7, that is 343. Subtracting these two and cancelling this one with this one. So the finally you get, after simplification, you get the answer 62.48 cubic centimeter. But the weight of brass in 1 centimeter cube. See, in question they given whose density is given this one. So that is equal to 17.3 gram. So total weight equal to this 17.3 multiplied by this volume. What we found just before, no? That one, 62.48. Multiply these two. you get the answer 1080.90 grams. Therefore, the total weight is 1080.9 grams. Is the answer to sum. Example 7.23. If the radii of circular ends of a frustum, which is 45 centimeter high, are 28 centimeter and 7 centimeter. Find the volume of the frustum. See here, radii. Radii given, circular ends of a frustum, which is 85 centimeter height. So that height is 45 centimeter height, or 28 centimeter and 7 centimeter. So the radius, upper radius is 7 centimeter and that lower radius is 28 centimeter. Height is 45. You are all know that frustum shape. This is the that shape. This is the height between two radiuses. This is upper radius. This is lower radius. The smaller one is upper 7 centimeter and the bigger radius bottom lower one is 28 centimeter. Okay. See, let H be the height and small r be the top radius and capital R be the bottom radius. Given that, what is given? H equal to 45 centimeter, capital R equal to 28 centimeter, small r equal to 7 centimeter. Now you find volume, because in question they asked us to find volume. Find the volume. So volume equal to, write the formula to find volume of frustum. Okay, 1 by 3 pi capital R squared plus capital R into small r plus small r squared into h cubic units. Now substitute the corresponding values. 1 by 3, value of pi is 22 by 7, capital R is 28, so 28 squared, then capital R into small r, so 28 into 7, small r is 7, so 7 squared, h is 45. Okay, now expand this one, 28 squared, 28 into 28. Okay, that is 7844. Then 28 into 7, 96 plus 7 squared, 49. Multiply, add everything. While squaring, you get 784. Okay, then multiplying these two, you get. So now add these three. You are getting 1029 and height is 45. Then cancel three table, 3 one time. 45 15 times. Okay, now multiply the terms in the numerator and divide the answer by 7. So finally you get 48,510. Therefore, the volume of the frustum is 48,510 centimeter cube is the answer. Next sum. Example 7.24. A toy is in the shape of cylinder surrounded by hemisphere. Okay, toy is in the shape of cylinder. It's in the shape of cylinder surrounded by a hemisphere. So one hemisphere surround that one. Okay, the height of the toy is 25 centimeter. Find the total surface area of the toy if its common diameter is 12 centimeter. So what you have to find here? Find total surface area, that is TSA. You have to find TSA of the toy if its common diameter. So diameter is common for both cylinder and hemisphere. That is common diameter. Common diameter means what? This portion. This is common for the cylindrical portion and hemisphere. Okay. See the diagram. Consider this is the toy. See here. First consider, see. This is cylinder. So here it's in the shape of this one, cylinder. Now see this one. I'm hide this. See the top portion. See, this is sphere. Is it clear? Diagram is, it looks like hemisphere. Okay. Now I hide this one, means see, it is in cylinder. Okay. Now this is clear. The total height, this is 25. Okay. Okay. Here one toy that is in shape of cylinder. That cylinder is surrounded by hemisphere. Okay. Let small r and h be the radius and height of the cylinder respectively. Given that diameter d equal to 12 centimeter. So radius, diameter is 12, means how you find radius, divide that one by 2. So 12 by 2 equal to 6 centimeter. Total height of the toy is 25 centimeter. It's given in question, height of the toy. So total height of the toy is 25 centimeter. Now you find the height of cylindrical portion. Therefore height of the cylindrical portion equal to total height minus this radius, radius of the hemisphere 6. So 25 minus 6, that is 19. So the height of the cylindrical portion is how much? 19. Okay. Now what you have to find? See the question. Find total surface area. So that means TSA. You have to find TSA of the toy. That is equal to CSA of a cylinder, because here one cylinder. Then CSA of a hemisphere, see this top portion, hemisphere, plus base area of the cylinder. Here this base area, this area, this is, you know, always base area is in the form of circle. So it is in circle shape. Now write the corresponding formulas. CSA of a cylinder, formula is 2 pi r h. CSA of a hemisphere, formula is 2 pi r squared. Then base area of cylinder, I already said base area is in the form of circle. So area of circle is formula pi r squared. So that pi r squared. Now see, in all the terms pi and r is common. Okay, here all the terms. So I am taking pi and r outside. In first term, the remaining one is 2h. So I am writing 2h. Then here 2r. So 2r. See here, only r only. Okay. Now see, pi r 2h. Here 2r plus r. R means what? 1r. 2 plus 1, 3. So this is 3r. 3r square units. Now substitute the values. Value of pi is 22 by 7. R. R is 6. So 6 into 2h. So h is how much? 19. So 2 into 19 plus 3r. 3 into 6. So 19 2s are 38. 16 3s are 18. Add these two. We are getting 56. Then simplifying this one, multiply and divide by 7. So you get the answer 1056. Therefore TSA of the toy is 1056 centimeter squared, because here area, so the unit is square. TSA of a toy is 1056 centimeter squared. Next one, example 7.25. a jewel box. See the figure, it's given in the figure. You are all see jewel box, most of you having at home. Is in the shape of cuboid of a dimension 30 centimeter into 15 centimeter into 10 centimeter, surrounded by a half part of a cylinder. See this one, half part of cylinder, that means half of the cylinder. See, consider that cylinder, you are in home, gas connection, you are having cylinder, or best example is your water bottle. Most of the water bottles are in cylinder shape, no? So half means you cut that bottle in half, in middle, so you are getting half portion. See, the jewel box in base is in cuboid. Best example for cuboid is your pencil box, geometry box. That is example of cuboid. Then that box is surrounded by half part of the cylinder. You can see this portion, this is the top portion, this is half part of the cylinder. Then this base is pencil box, geometry box. Then this is cylinder. Yes, diagram is clear. Okay, so let L be H1, breadth and height of the cuboid. L means length, B means breadth, H1 means height. So here dimensions are given, no? Length, breadth and height. Okay, and also take radius and H2 are the radius of the cylinder. See why? Because here we are taking height 1 and 2, means we are having two heights here. One is for cuboid that box height, and another one is for this cylindrical half part of the cylinder, no, that height. So we are taking h1 for cuboid and h2 for that half of the cylinder. Okay, so this r, lb, h1 r for cuboid and radius and h2 height is for the cylindrical part. Okay, now see what is given. Volume of box, volume of box equal to volume of cuboid, this base cuboid, plus half part. Half is given, so half means what? 1/2 volume of cylinder, 1/2 volume of the cylinder. Okay, now write the formula. Volume of cuboid, L into B into H. In lower classes you studied L, B, H. Okay, then half into volume of cylinder formula, pi r squared h2, because we are taking this height is h2, so I am writing here h2 cubic units. Now substitute the values for that is cuboid. Dimensions are given here, 30 into 15 into 10. Substitute the all values here, plus 1/2. This value of pi is 22/7 r squared. R is how much? 15/2 into 15/2. Height is 30. Okay, and now cancel this one. 22 into 2, then this 2 into 30. After simplification, you getting this answer, and for this one, this answer. Adding these two, you get 7151.79. This is the volume of the box. Volume of this given box is 7151.79 centimeter cube. Next, see the question. Find volume and TSA of a box. So now we found volume. Next one is TSA. So you write the formula. TSA of the box equal to TSA of the cuboid plus half into CSA of a cylinder. Same here, volume means you have to take volume of cuboid plus half into volume of cylinder. TSA means take CSA of a cuboid half, because here half part, so taking half and CSA of a cylinder. Write the formula. CSA of a cuboid is 2 into L plus B into H1 plus CSA of a cylinder formula, 2 pi r H2. These two get cancelled. Substitute the values. 2 into L, length is given 45, into height is 10, plus 22/7 into radius 15/2 into H2, that is 30. Simplify all this. 2 and 30, you cancel means 15 times. So multiply the numerators and divide that 1/7. You get 707.14. Here, multiply these two numbers. 45 into 10 is 450. 450 into 2 is 900. Now add these two. While adding here, decimal is there. So how you add? 900, put two zeros, then 707.14. Decimal part, write the decimal part separately. Now you add, okay, 7016. So you get 1607.14. Therefore, TSA of a box equal to 1607.14 centimeter squared, because this is area. So the unit is 2.